Hey, today we are going to implement basic layout and navigation between the pages for a personal finance dashboard application. To start, let's take a look at how routing works in Next.js. Next.js has a file system-based router built on top of the concept of pages. A page is a React component exported from a file in the pages directory. Pages are associated with a route based on their file name. For example, this index.tsx file is associated with the root route because it's placed directly under the pages directory. I will clean up and rename this one right away. In our app, we want to have the following URL routes. Root route, we will call it overview. It will contain various reports and provide us a bird's eye view of our personal finance situation. Bank accounts, where we will manage our bank accounts. Categories, where we will manage our expense and income categories. Transactions, where we will be able to see the list of our transactions, add new ones or modify existing ones. So let's create page components for them. Bankaccounts.tsx, categories.tsx and transactions.tsx. Now these pages should be associated with the corresponding routes. Let's see. That works. Since our pages will have more components and files related to them, let's move these three pages under the directory and rename the files to index.tsx. Next.js routing also supports nesting, which could be done by creating a nested folder structure. Files will automatically be routed in the same way. Let me show you. Create index.tsx under pages transactions all and navigate to transactions/all. And voila! But we won't need nested routing just yet, so I will remove it. One more cool feature Next.js routing supports is dynamic routes. Let's say I want to have a dedicated route for a particular transaction. You can add brackets to a page file name to create a dynamic route. Let's export a transaction component. The matched path parameter will be sent as a query parameter to the page, and it will be merged with the other query parameters. You can get that parameter by importing useRouterHook from NextRouter and take the ID from the query object. Let's try it. Multiple dynamic route segments work the same way. The following page will match the route transactions /123/acomment, and its query object will look like this. Dynamic routes can be extended to catch all paths by adding three dots inside the bracket. For example, this page not only matches transactions 123, but also transactions 123/A, transactions 123/A/B, and so on. Now you should be familiar with the basics of how routing works in Next.js applications. Time to create our app layout and header components with navigation between the pages. Let's start from app.tsx, which is Next.js application entry point. The purpose of my app component is to wrap your entire Next.js application with any necessary global providers or components and to provide a common layout across all pages of your application. The component prop refers to the page component that will be rendered on the browser. Let's import a layout component, which we will create in a second, and wrap the page component with it so that every page would have a header at the top. Now create components directory and layout component. Import a head component provided by Next.js that allows setting the HTML document head content such as title, meta tags, and links. Add main element. Within this block, we will render the header component. It will display the navigation links, profile picture, etc. And children, where the children will be one of the pages in the app. Add some CSS styling with Tailwind classes to the elements to set background color, heights, paddings, and stuff like that. Time to create the header component itself. We will wrap everything in a header element. For the now bar, we will use Daisy UI component, which we installed in a previous video. To do that, simply give an appropriate navbar class names to the elements. Navbar will consist of three main sections: navbar start, navbar center, and navbar end. Let's start with navbar start. It has a drop-down component, again from Daisy UI. This drop-down will be visible for smaller screens only. This drop-down is opened by clicking on a label that contains an SVG icon of three horizontal lines. Within the dropdown, we will display a menu of custom navlink components, which will redirect the users to the pages we created earlier. We will create the navlink component in a few seconds. Each navlink component has a name prop, which is used to display the name of the page, a href prop, which is used to set the link to the page, and the bottom border prop, which will be used to determine whether or not the navlink component should have a bottom border. In other words, whether or not it's active or not. By default, the bottom border prop will be set to true. Within the navbar start, let's also display a span with the name of the website. Now, navbar center section. It will be displayed only on larger screens. Inside, one more menu with the same links. This time, we won't pass bottom border prop as its default value is true, and that's exactly what we want here. Finally, navbar end section, where we will add a dropdown with the user avatar. It won't be functional just yet, but once we will implement user auth, it will contain links to the settings page and logout. Okay, time to create navlink component. Define an interface for props it accepts and destructure all of them. Additionally, setting the bottom border prop default value to true. Now to perform an actual navigation, or more specifically client-side transition between the routes, we will use link component imported from next link. Give it a href from props and render a page name. This link will have either a bottom or left border on a currently active navlink. To ease applying class names conditionally, I will install class names library, a simple JavaScript utility for conditionally joining class names together. Now assign either a bottom border or left border tailwind class to border class const and pass the class names to the link component. Pay attention though that we are passing an object to second parameter because we want this particular class name to be appended only if the link is currently active. To determine if this link is currently active, we can use useRouter hook from nextRouter. Take current path name and compare it with the navlink's href. Let's take a look at how that looks in action. The navigation between the pages is working, the border class is correctly indicating which page is currently active, the user avatar dropdown currently is not functional, but that's okay. Let's simulate a smaller screen, and it seems everything is working correctly here as well. One single piece is missing. We want our navlink to contain an icon to make things nicer, and of course we will need a lot more icons in our finance dashboard application. For that, we will install Font Awesome libraries. For these icons to work, we need to do a bit of configuration. Import styles.css config and library from Font Awesome SVG core. Import fast icons from free solid SVG icons. Set the config auto add CSS to false since we imported the CSS manually. Finally, add the imported icons to the library. Open the navlink component again. Import icon prop type definition and font awesome icon component. Update our navlink props interface to accept icon prop and adjust the prop destructuring and render the font awesome icon component with an icon prop. Now we can update all the navlink component usages and pass the desired icon for each navlink. Import the icons you want and simply pass them as a prop to navlink. Here's the final result. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. To make sure you don't miss the next episode, please consider subscribing. Thank you for watching and see you on the next one.